She is still riding there. Jamie, this is a, this is really, I'm really staggered with the funny all you guys. I really see it, looking at some of the guys, I'm really fabulous, I thank, I'm a good friend, I call him a friend, not to thank you all for even putting this together. Like I said, you go to Midwest Conference, and the reality is that we face and not the same reality. So I'd like to see about approaching this guy, please. And I am that type of person, I like to come at it a different way. If you ever want to know anything about Wilbur Rollins, is I am a simple person. I believe that everything should be broken down to the simplest terms. And once we get to the simplest terms, then we can build up from there. You want to teach a piece of music, you pass it out, you got to start with the introduction. You want to start with the tuba line. What's the first note? What's the duration of that note? So it's got to be broken down to its lowest terms, period. Okay, so what we have here, guys, is put together, this actually is my first PowerPoint presentation. Never did this one before, so I thank you for having me do it. The purpose of the high school band room, and when it comes to branding yourself and the band program app, I'm going to start with a curriculum essential document. Okay, guys, this document, because we're faced with more content than we are reasonably address. You know, we're obligated to make choices and frame problems. I'll leave this up here for you to read this because you don't want anybody sitting up here like a talking head dog. But this is very, very essential into what it is that we have to do and provide as a band member. Okay? These words, and they come to a slide that looks like this. Understandings that are worth being committed, essential learning, content standards, and a high school grad, a productive citizen. The purpose of the band member, in my opinion, in this day and age, is to create productive citizens. Breaking it down to the lowest terms, guys. About 20 years ago, the United States of America, the President of the United States, embarked upon a situation whereas young girls were having babies at an alarming rate. 13, 14, 15-year-old little girls were having babies. It got so bad to whereas they started to say, don't have sex. So bad now to whereas they started to pass out contraceptives in the middle school programs. We're going to give you condoms. Now they're saying, we know you're having sex, just protect yourself. So because of that, a 14-year-old child has a baby. She's being raised by her mother, right? The 14-year-old child has a child who's now an infant. Who do you think is going to raise the infant? The mother of a 14-year-old child. Here's the strange part. After about 2 or 3 years, the mother that's raising the 14-year-old and raising the infant is now raising the 14-year-old and the infant, which makes the infant and the 14-year-old what? Siblings. They're siblings, they're brothers and sisters. They're being raised by one person, which means that now that the parent who's raising the 14 and the infant, that parent is now getting older. That parent now is starting to get up in 50, 60, 70 years of age. You can't run around with a child like that. Now when that child gets to 5th, 6th, 7th grade, who's going to parent the child? Did the parent learn parenting skills yet? He did not learn those skills yet. Which means that now these children are coming into your bedroom, they haven't learned what? Basic fundamental life skills. They haven't learned that. Yes, we do have the obligation of teaching these children how to read music, how to play these instruments. This is going to happen. Honestly, I know it is. I've heard some people talk about scheduling differences and all this other stuff. You have to just be, honestly, you got to be Charlie Wilson, man. You got to be Charlie Wilson. Charlie Wilson, I don't even know how old Charlie Wilson really is. Because I saw him at the Essence Festival, and I got tired of looking at him on stage dancing and running around like some 12, 14, 15-year-old guy. His hair's still black, he's still, I don't understand what it is, but he has evolved. He's taken his situation and he's turned it into what he needs to do to still be relevant in today's society. So yes, scheduling is changed. So I'm speaking about being a band director in this new age, where you might not have classes that, I've heard my man say he has classes, he can do this and that, he scheduled his beginners in this class, and the intermediate in that class. All of us don't have that. I remember just 5 to 6 years ago when I had a principal named Mary Ellis Lawrence who understood the importance of teaching music to children. children. She made it possible for me to have all of my virtues in the band. I had the entire marching band in one class. 90 people in one class. The band was right across from the hallway. She was so excited. She would come over to class and she would throw her scarf over her shoulder. She would just, she would be so happy to see the children in there reading the music and learning. The music was nice. And then we got a new principal. Oh, I'm sorry. And then our test score came up. And then now we are down to a B-plus school. And now with a new principal, the State Board of Education is running everything. Now you have Eldridge Charter Schools coming in. Now you have the principal afraid of Eldridge Charter Schools. And now the teachers are not afraid of Wilyria. We understand that's our boss. They make decisions that we have to cap, we have to cover. So now the principal is looking for Eldridge Charter School. Me as a teacher, I am answering to the principal. The parents are afraid of the children because they can call 911. You put your hands on them and call the police. All right? I'm afraid for my job. The principal's afraid for his job. The Eldridge Charter will move their charter school. The State Board of Education is answering to the United States of America. Guess what, Dad? The children are answering to no one. They're afraid of nothing. You can't do them anything. You can't. Just a couple of years ago, I used to swing a piece of wood. Swung so much wood every day. And then that started to become a problem. And then so you have to adjust. You have to adapt. You can't get stuck in your old ways. And then now is I had the threat of swinging the wood. Keep it up. I'm going to take it back. I'm going to brush your butt. Now you can't even make the threat. Just as early as last year, I was called into the superintendent's office for hollering at a child. Get your ass in line. He hollered at me. I got 2 days suspension for hollering, which means that now I have to speak in a tone that's so relaxing and calm. I have to create an environment. If I'm saying all this, guys, to say you have to adapt to your current situation, all right? So this is the essentials, the curriculum essentials draft. This is how it's, but this is how it's supposed to look, okay? But going forward, guys, this is really what it is, breaking it down to the last and final term, lower term. We have to start teaching these children life competencies. I don't know about you guys, but I've got some kids who really don't, they don't understand how fair play, honest sportsmanship. They don't understand about how to just even live a competent life. You know, leads a balanced life, exhibits physical fitness, knows good nutrition, rules, stays safe and drug-free, knows how to have fun and relax, manages anger and stress, exhibits self-sufficiency, self-confidence, and finishes tasks. These skills that these children that we're working with today, they don't even possess this yet. Which means as a band director, if you could just rearrange the furniture in your mind, you have to understand that in order for you to produce a top-quality program or a band, you have to produce this first. Each one of these children must have these skills in order to be a part of the overall group. They have to have these skills. Demonstrate time management skills. How many times you see a kid, you play trumpet, it's 15 minutes before practice starts. I know your ass don't know section B of the song that we're about to play. I've already emailed you through Smart Music all of your parts. How can you come to rehearsal and not know your part? All you have is one part. How do you do that? Well, so that means that you don't understand time management. You know, broad-based knowledge, practice skills, such as cooking, sewing, driving, and mapping. These things, honestly, guys, I know it sounds like it's out of our realm, but through the music program, we can actually teach this. We go on a band trip, right? Let's just take this last one. Demonstrate time management skills. And let's even with teaching skills. We go on a band trip. We take the kids to a resort. We get the resort to come give us the decent rate. And I'm not going to lie, we do a pretty decent job of raising funds. Because in the city of New Orleans, where marching band is very prevalent, it's also a great opportunity for you to make some very serious funds for your program. At least 3 days a week, I can march in the convention center and make $2,000 for 20 minutes worth of work. Put the uniforms on, load the children up on the bus, go to the convention center. There's a convention of about maybe 6,000 to 7,000, maybe 60,000. I think it's as big as 60,000 to 70,000 people. And then the band marches in. We march around one time, we come out. It's $2,000. We do that 3 times a week. That's $6,000 a week. $12,000 every other week. $24,000 a month. We're doing that 10 months a year. $240,000 can be generated just from convention. So what I'm going to ask you a question. So, and I'm not just upholding what's happening to all of them, man. I know we have to really do some things to our fans, but you guys can understand that these skills we have to teach. I have to teach these children this. You know, so that raising that money and marching in those parades, I'm not even including the parade monies, nor the fundraisers, you know, none of that stuff, not to mention the extra contracts that we may have. You know, so having these skills being taught to our children is better than raising the monies and all that stuff. So we're going on a band trip. I'm coming right back to you. We go to the hotel. We have a meal set up in the ballroom where we have every child sit down at a table, six chairs to a table. White linen cloth. No, we're not eating steak at the table. We can eat some chicken breast. We eat mashed potatoes. And I purposely asked the people to add a little food color to the mashed potato, make it purple. I'm going to make it not like purple. You know, maybe so now they're like, what is this purple potato? I don't want that. You never tried. You know what it is. You know, so, and then now before you eat, now it's like, okay, guys, everybody do a favor, pick up your dinner fork. And that way, now here comes the person who's going to come out and explain to each child what the utensils are. This is your dinner fork. This is your dinner fork. When you finish with your first course, then what do you do? How do you, hey, bro, I'm finished. No. You take your fork and your knife and cross them on the X and you sit at next step. Way to know that you're finished with that course and he can take it away and bring you your next course. So I'm just saying to you guys, teaching these life competencies is very, very important in our band. You know, so go ahead, sir.
Well, my action was, well, how do you go about branching out like that when you're outside the world?
I mean, I don't think, is there anyone in here that's not faced with children who are, have not been properly raised and reared, who does not understand? Well, what's got to happen is you got to find your way in your particular community, your area, wherever you are. I guarantee there's a lot of money making adventures. Or create your own. Create your own. I have a band director, man. I know out in Atlanta, Mr. Satan. Man, this guy, I walked in his band room, we took a trip out there. I'm thinking we're about to go in practice. This guy's got almost 300 mattresses in the band room, just mattresses. With mattresses in the museum. This is a fundraiser. I've never heard this before. He said, Mr. Rock, by the end of this weekend, we're going to make $1.2 million. I said, doing what? Selling mattresses. As I was in the band room, I watched all of the faculty and staff, the community, the parents. I mean, who in here has bought a new mattress in the last year? Everybody, how about the last 5 years? Yeah, so everybody said, you know, maybe 5 years, you're going to buy a mattress. You know, so, and that was one of them. He also had another one that he did. And I'm just saying, he came up with some real creative ideas to make money. And I'm not talking about $250, $300 fan cloth and all of this. I'm talking about real money so you can do it 2-3 times a year and move on and teaching these children life competencies. All right? He did one. I'll give you another. He did. He went to the Lexus dealership. He told the Lexus dealership he needs a fundraiser. He said to them, I want you to bring out a Lexus SUV to the football game. I want you as the dealership to print up the tickets. We're going to buy this car from you. The tickets were $5 a ticket. Every football game, they brought this Lexus out there and they put it on this big, beautiful red carpet all the way in the corner of the arena, the stadium. And Van Houston Club sold $5 tickets to win a brand new Lexus Jeep every football game. By the third football game, the Jeep was paid for. By the time they had got the playoff season, the man had raised something like $2.6 million in just a Lexus, and he didn't pay for nothing. The dealership brought the car there. The dealership laid out the carpet. They paid for the raffle tickets. All the parents did was sell the tickets. So the fundraising part is about, is going to be about you coming up with creative ideas to make it happen. You have to find a way to make it happen. You might not don't have a Lexus dealership in your area. You might have, you might be torn over. You could go there. And I, and he sent me a video. Them calling out the winning team. And it was a 21-year-old young man who had won that Jeep. Man, when I tell you that guy jumped down out that stadium and ran over that car and hugged that car. And everybody else in the stadium, and his mindset was, that's nice. But he wants to get everybody in that stadium who didn't buy a ticket to see the exaltation in this guy's heart and his mind and spirit. He wanted them to feel that. So come next year, the car going to be paid for in week one.
Right.
You'll make $5 million. I think fundraising is about you coming up with a different way of approach, a different way to do it. I also say this to you guys, don't let this day pass without speaking to this young man about what else you, because you didn't say this to them. I was back there listening. You didn't tell them that you are this part of the region. You are the Conselman rep. I wanted instruments. I'm down there playing. I'm not there. I found out, too. He explained this to me. I'm saying, God, I can't get my damn trumpets to play in tune for nothing. He want to shoot them out. He said, what kind of horns you playing on? I told him, I said, I have some this, and that, and this others. He said, well, that's why they sound like this, that, and the others. All of, if you want your trumpets to be all to sound the same, they have to be playing on what? The same instrument. I said, well, I can't afford that. Let me take care of it. And within about 30 days, huh? 30 days, I started to receive instruments. Brand new sousaphones, what, 15 trombones, F attachment, big 5400 FL shanks. I took them to Paris, and the people at the conservatory was like, where did you get this horn from? I said, well, I got this from Mr. Sackler. We heard of this instrument, we've just never seen it. You know, so I mean, there are some things, all these brand new trumpets. I mean, I got a whole band of brand new instruments. Just talking to this guy right here, and I think my bill is what, 20,000, what I pay, 20,000 a year for 4 years. I might have paid $80,000 for almost $300,000 intervention, or some kind of when you gave me an in-kind grant, you gave me another something. I mean, it was, guys, talk to this guy, if you need instruments, and he'll give you exactly what you need. I just want to say that, because again, this is the whole thing about information, and I just want to say that, all right? So talk to this guy about it, yes, sir. No, because Mr. Sanford taught me that the new instruments are performance instruments. Right. And your old instruments are, you wouldn't go out in your brand new Jordans and go practice basketball. Right. You wouldn't do that, you know. So I need the old instruments. So moving right along. Moving right along. So again, and I wanted to spend a couple, and I know I don't have a whole lot of time, but I'm going to go real quick to do this stuff. We did talk about life conferences, right? So check this out, though. What about communication, speaking, and writing? What about that? How many times do these kids, we have to start to teach them how to communicate, how to use their vocabulary, their verbiage. So in the band room now, if you ask them, a couple of guys now, when I get on the podium, my verbiage is impeccable. The way that I speak to them, everybody is yes, sir, no, sir. The words that I use, I try to search for bigger, broader words. I try to make them in their minds saying, what is he saying? And then now you want to go back and research. Writes and speaks, I guess, when I put this in bold print, you know, thoughtfully and articulate to form and to express one's thinking. This is just the definition of what I think this is. You know, not to mention moving forward to the multicultural and global perspective. Understanding global customs, economics, literature, history, politics, and religion. Geographic and demographics, understanding the contributions of different cultures to our society, especially in New Orleans, we have a mixture of everybody. You know? Again, if you don't understand this and you don't respect it, then you're pretty much not being raised as what I would consider to be a productive citizen. So as a band director, that is one of my main goals, is to produce a productive citizen. I am Wilbur Rollins, I grew up in very impoverished areas. He come out of desire. You know what I mean? I don't know if you guys can understand it or not. Things were very, very bad. We were poor. We were was so poor that we didn't even eat meat on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday.